Hi, I'm Cameron Chai from azocleantech, and I'm speaking today to Brendan Bateman, who's a partner at Clayton Utz, and he's going to tell us a little bit about their firm and what they do. And first of all, if you could tell us a little bit about who Clayton Utz are and what they do, that'd be great.
Yeah, sure, Cameron. Clayton Utz is a national top-tier firm in Australia. We have offices in Melbourne, Brisbane, Sydney, Canberra, Darwin, and also in Perth. We have a broad client base, the top ASX 100, as well as a lot of other specialised companies. We have significant practices in energy resources, infrastructure, government work that we do as well. And so we have a significant practice in the sense of the types of clients who we do work for, ranging from financial institutions to major corporate resource companies to international Chinese companies looking to invest in Australia and so on.
Okay, you head up the climate change group, and so you guys do a lot of stuff, a lot of business in the clean tech area?
Yes, we do. Clean tech has been a focus, one of the areas of focus for the climate change group. We've identified clean tech as being an area which is really going to be a significant driver going forward to deal with the climate change challenges that the country is, indeed the world, faces. Clean tech isn't necessarily seen as being sexy, much in the same way as energy efficiency. It's about a lot of very intelligent people working in small premises with very little money, developing their ideas and trying to commercialise their inventions effectively. But inevitably, those technologies are the ones that come to bear and will provide a significant way in which we can try and abate not only emissions, but also deal with associated issues such as water quality and also waste and how we treat waste and deal with waste. So it's the whole environmental aspect, that sustainability aspect that we see the future for clean tech in.
So you guys have helped smaller companies, startups and things like that get off their feet and out into the marketplace? And
certainly we can do that. Primarily our client base would probably not necessarily be the small company startup, but be the investor. The angel, the venture capitalists, or indeed the private equity are looking to invest in these corporations. So we'd look at doing the due diligence work to assist the financier to work out the risks and the way in which they might want to structure the corporation or structure the way in which the money's being paid. And so we look at being in first port of call, being able to support the financiers looking to invest into those areas. Certainly we can help also the small startup companies too in terms of IP, tax and a whole range of other services that we can.
Okay, and you're also involved with emissions trading. Can you tell us how that all works and what your involvement is in that?
I don't know if we've got enough time to talk about how emissions trading works, but we're on the Department of Climate Change's panel to advise on the development of the Australian Emissions Trading Scheme, the Carbon Pollution Reduction Scheme. We have been providing advice to the department on very discrete areas around the design elements of the scheme. We've also been doing a lot of work with our industry clients, particularly in the resources sector and the energy sector, who are obviously very significant liable entities under the proposed scheme, dealing with issues as mundane as, say, operational control issues over who controls a particular facility, looking at them, significant liability issues associated with which entity is liable, how they can pass through on the costs of that through the supply chain, and indeed looking at issues associated with their entitlement if they're in an emissions intensive trade exposed area, their qualification for that industry assistance.
Okay, another area that you're quite heavily involved with is energy efficient buildings. Could you tell us what your involvement is in that area?
Yeah, sure. We've been looking at trying to assist. The issue with energy efficiency, much in the way of clean tech, is getting it up in investment at scale. Energy efficiency technology is out there already. It's about actually trying to generate a critical mass behind it to get it rolled out at scale. And one of the, if you take the building industry for an example, particularly the commercial building industry, there are a lot of impediments to that occurring simply because you've got so many different stakeholders that you need to get the consent of. To get their buy-in in order for this rollout to occur. And it's what's described as being split incentives. Incentives of who's going to pay for the capital cost of it, who's going to take the benefit and so on. What we've been trying to do is work with some of the larger financial institutions to develop products that seeks to break down those split incentives, so to speak, to achieve a win-win for all the participants. And we've been trying to work with those financial institutions and governments about coming up with a model or a design which will assist in the rollout at scale of energy efficiency retrofit programs across large commercial sectors. And when you talk about, say, a fund, a property fund, fund which might have ownership of a large number of commercial tenancies, commercial buildings, then there's a potentially significant amount of work that could be done in the energy efficiency space.
All right, so that gives people a bit of a quick taste of what you guys do in the clean tech sector. And if they want any more information about what you guys do, they can obviously contact you through your website.
Absolutely.
Yep, so that's claytonutz.com.
And that's it.
All right.
No IE.
Fantastic. All right, Brendan, thanks for much for your time. And we hope that people come to speak to you when they've got needs in the clean tech area.
Please do so. Thank you.
Okay, thanks very much.